Happy morning, friends. So we are in a very important day to see how to prepare for a tough paper called Jurisprudence, Interpretation and General Law. Why do I say it's a tough paper? To initially start with, it will look as if it is tough. But once you know the nuances of how to prepare and how to crack it, it is going to be very easy and simple. Now we are very happy that LICA has started with the classes for CS, and I am the founder for Sri Mathangi Academy in Chennai. We both are doing it collaboratively for certain subjects, though I take all the subjects separately, still for two subjects, which is Jurisprudence, Interpretation and General Law, and for Capital Market and Security Law, or otherwise called Securities Market and Capital Markets, we are conducting the classes. So let's go directly into this session to go and see what is actually there. So I can also share the screen, see this perspective of we covering what is going to be there in this jiggle. I hope you are able to see this particular screen that is there. Guys, are you able to see this?
Yes.
Okay. Now first, what is our first botheration? The first botheration is, sir, how much is the marks? We know it's 100 marks. And we also know for all the law papers, the marks are only 100. It is 100 marks. That too, descriptive. It is not going to be objective. We know that for costing, NFM, strategic management, tax, everything is going to be MCQ. That means it is going to be more objective type. All the laws, including Jurisprudence, Interpretation, General Law, it is going to be what? It is going to be descriptive. So you need to write all the 3 hours to ensure to get a minimum exemption. So we are here to take up classes, not just to pass with 40 marks or to wait for aggregate to happen. Somehow God should help me to give me that 50 marks aggregate so that I can finish my work. No, I don't think that will help you, because CS should be a part of your life and not just to study exams and get 40 marks, correct? So we don't study for a professional course to get 40 marks and pass, because at the end of the day, we are going to live with this. So we will usually say longevity personified. That means the law is for life, not just for exams. This I usually say because you should not stop restricting it to 40. Why not get 80 out of 100 or 90 out of 100? No parents is going to scold if you get more than 70, 80 marks. So obviously it is going to make your job really strong. You will feel really confident also. Why? Because you are going to again attempt that in the CA final examination. So you will be able to do things better when you wanted to do the papers easily. Now, question paper pattern. Now, there is no choices, one question with another. There can only be internal choices. So we need to be careful in this paper, because the choices, usually what they will say, question number one is compulsory, any three from the rest or any four from the rest. That's what they will try to do. Openly, you can leave one question which you do not know. But this is not going to be the case when it comes to be, when it comes to be here, because the purpose, you need to know that it is not going to be just the examination. It is going to be more than that. So the perspective is very simple. Compulsory question. It is going to make you compulsory, and you should also ensure that you are going to cover this on a question paper pattern basis. Question number one, compulsory. Definitely you need to write 5 marks, 4 questions. It is going to be 20 marks. You should write all the questions. You have got no other option. 4 questions into 5 marks, 20 marks. Second question, either or choice. There will be a 2A, 2B. Any of this one question you need to concentrate. Third is compulsory. Fourth is compulsory. Fifth is compulsory. The beauty of the fifth question is, there is going to be 2 8 marks questions. So you need to write almost like 1 to 1.5 pages with the keywords underlined or the bullet points. That's very important. Only the sixth question is going to be either or choice along with the second question. See, please, what I'm going to underline, I'm making coloring on question number 2 and question number 6. It is going to be either or choice. You need to attend all this. So that means you need to know what is important concepts, what are the categories of ABC. Guys, see what is the next thing I am going to show here. I have my 18 papers to be around here. So in that 18, you need to understand what is A category, what is B category, what is C category, because we know that there are 17 chapters. All the 17, will you be able to study full 100%? I don't think so. We will not be able to do it. But still, if you wanted to do, you can, provided if you know the A, B, C categories. What is more important? What is okay? What is not important? But just if you glance, it is enough. So sources of law, I'm going to mark that as A category. Why A category? Because there are various people who has defined various definitions, various doctrines. WDW, what does that mean? Who defined what? There are various people who defined it. Please understand also in the tabs that I have selected for chapter number one, you can see definition by Austin. You can see Rousseau's definition. You can see Salmon's definition. You can see Kelsen's definition. You can see Bentham's definition. Like that, there are various people who have defined all these things. Why I have prepared all this? Because you should know that we are not just seeking for the sake of seeking for a particular webinar or for a career guidance. We are already equipped with what we wanted to have. All this, we have already prepared the list. So you should know that once the session gets completed, you are getting an utmost confidence to get a minimum exemption, minimum 60 marks in this paper. Now, you know why this is A category. See how many people who define what definitions are there. What are the criticisms for one's definition? For example, if anybody wants to say, if Bentham wants to come back with the definition would be criticized by another person by giving another definition. Once you know this connection only, you will know that it is going to be easy. Otherwise, you cannot even touch this paper when it comes to the examination hall. So A category. Yes, so this is going to be one important thing for A category. Then Constitution of India, again A category. Guys, if you have done with CSEET, your CS Foundation, we would have already done this in legal aptitude paper. The paper number two, which is called Legal Aptitude and Logical Reasoning. In that, the legal aptitude paper, the first chapter is Constitution of India. Here, it is not just the normal what president will do, what governor will do, what Lok Sabha will do, what Rajya Sabha will do, what are the articles that you have in each of these constitutions, where the courts will come into picture, how many writs are there, 5 writs, all that who would have studied in CSET would know. Anybody who has done CSET and come here? Who has done CSET, CS Foundation and have come here to this session? You can just give me your voice. CSET, anybody has done and come here? Okay, if you have done, that means you will understand what I am talking about. Articles from 14 to 32, you need to be thorough with the numbers in CSET. Here they will openly ask you question and answer. Descriptive you need to write, so we need to be careful about it. So A category. IOS, again A category. Guys, you should understand, interpretation of statutes has to be connected with General Clauses Act. It has to be connected with General Clauses Act for a simple reason. One is interpretation and construction. Another is act itself. You know when there will be an act. The bill can become an act only when there is going to be a Lok Sabha's approval, Rajya Sabha's approval, assent of president. The beauty is you will study about Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, president, everything in the previous chapter, which is called Constitution of India. In IOS, directly you will read about construction. In GCA, you will say in this act, how they have framed. So there is a beautiful connection between your chapter number 2, chapter number 3, and chapter number 4. But chapter number 4 that we are having as a General Clause Act is your C category only. Not a big deal to remember. If you are confident about interpretation of statutes, it is going to be perfect. It is going to be perfect. You don't need to do anything more. Extra some 5 questions, your fourth chapter will get over. So these 3 chapters, I'm going to make it and I'm going to give you one simple color for a simple reason. All these 3 are fantastically connected concepts. Next is administrative laws. Very normally, how a justice will be given. What are the general damages that we have? in Indian Contract Act, if you study, guys, breach of contract. There will be 5 damages when there is a breach of contract. Now, this damages are not that. This is even more general damages, general liabilities that we will try to have. Many unusual type of questions can be come. So this can be a B category, unusual questions. So anytime they can highlight and ask this when it comes to the examination. So be careful about it. Law of torque. Again, I will have to go back to CSEET, legal aptitude paper. Guys, you know, you should know why CS Foundation or CSEET is very important for us to study, because already you would have studied that as a basics. Here you will come and do a descriptive level of study. For your information, both LICA and Sri Matangi Academy takes the classes for the whole of CSEET. For CSEET, I take all the 4 papers, and LICA also has the faculties relating to it. Why am I connecting that now? Unless and until we conduct a foundation or a CSEET, you will not be able to have a touch on what is there in CS Executive. You have 5 laws in CS Executive. All the 5 laws are interconnected in some way or the other. You should understand that. Anyways, I am not going into the combination of 5 laws. We will concentrate on jurisprudence alone. Law of tort. Tort means civil wrong. Whatever the civil liabilities, civil wrongs, whatever the liabilities that we will try to have under this alone will be covered. Criminal, we will have a separate act. You should understand, tort is civil wrong. There will be 3 liabilities. Whether the injury is with damage or without damage, all that and all we will study. There are jargons which we will talk about here. Damnum sine injuria, injuria sine damnum. Like that, we will try to read the jargons or maxims and kind of liabilities that we will study. What is this SVB? Strict liability, vicarious liability, and vicarious liability of the state. So if you see this, I have prepared all these mnemonics for you to understand. You may not get anything right now, but all this, if you study, law of tort is over. But still, you will be able to understand it is going to be a B category. Now, listen carefully. I told the tort is going to be civil wrong. There are 2 liabilities, civil liability, criminal liability. Now, wait for this. I'll go and connect with company law. In company law, we have 29 chapters, 470 sections, 7 schedules. In that 29 chapters, the 3rd chapter, if you can remember, maybe the faculty who was taking company law would have told you, prospectus and allotment of securities. Have you heard about this chapter number 3, which we call it as PAS, prospectus and allotment of securities. In that, you will study about civil liability, criminal liability. What are the conditions if it's civil liability? Okay. What are the conditions if it's criminal liability? It is okay. Why am I studying that? Why am I connecting that with chapter 3 of Companies Act? Listen carefully. Law of tort is civil wrong, and civil procedure code is connected. See what I'm trying to do. I am giving a different color. Why I am giving you color? So that you can make yourself strong. See the 2 different colors that I have given here, the brown color, the light brown color. I have connected law of tort and civil procedure. Both are civil related procedures and civil related liabilities, appeals, offenses, penalties, compliance requirements, etc. What is your res subjudice, res sub judicata? What are the differences? What is judgment, decree, order? All these concepts you will have to connect with law of tort, because that is civil wrong. This is civil procedure. Civil procedure 1908. I hope you would have understood the connection. But the beauty is, civil procedure is A category. Tort is B category. Civil procedure is going to be A category. So combine this and study. Now, for any particular activity, you have a time limit. Generally, in company law, what we will say reasonable time. If they have not given a time limit, we will say it has to be completed within a reasonable time. We may not know what is reasonable time. It will be like a going concern concept. Correct? That means foreseeable future. What we will read in company law, members may come and members may go, but company will go on forever. So that means company will keep on be going. The process will keep on be going. but one particular activity or a contract or an agreement has to be completed within a particular time. Who, which act will tell in what time it has to be completed? Limitation Act 1963 will tell about what is the running of time, what is the period of limitation within what you should complete, what are your doctrines connected with the time, and there will be case-based questions in the examination. Very rarely they ask, but when they ask this, they are going to ask it from this particular chapter. Again, for your information, it is B category. Limitation Act 1963. Don't forget, you need to always connect with the Act. The moment when you connect with the Act, it is here. Now, let's take for an example. When I tell my name or when I give my name in the Zoom, I say it as CS or Bharat Kumar. CS, the professional degree, or initial, my father's name, Ramani. Bharat Kumar, my name. So how important is initial for a name? So important for you to tell. Exactly the same way, if you are going to tell an act, the year is going to be more an initial like that. How important is to connect act and years? It's like how you connect your initial and the name. So don't forget without giving it for your years when the act is there. So law of torque, all this and all is not the act, but it is going to be the rules and regulations. GCA Act, Limitation Act, Civil Procedure Act. Next is IPC. Listen carefully. I'm going to connect these two things in a different color. So when I use different colors, you will be able to understand it better. Yeah. So I will do this with the purple color. Why am I connecting this with the purple color? Listen carefully. When I connected with Chapter 3 of your company law, which is prospectus and allotment of securities, I told there is civil liability, criminal liability. Civil liability, I told tort and civil procedure code. Criminal liability, criminal procedure code and Indian Penal Code 1863. Criminal procedure is 1973. Indian Penal Code is 1860. Both are A category. The more you are positive, they are not going to ask a question on that. The more you are negative, there will be more questions on that in the professional examination. You understand what I mean to say? What is negative? Indian Penal Code. All the criminal activities, whatever there is going to be penalized, IPC. You would have seen many movies in Tamil or Malayalam or Telugu or Kannada. When the moment when the court scene comes, they would have used a section called 420. And they will say, as per the Indian Penal Code, IPC, this section, you need to punish that fellow. All this, we are going to study this in this particular CS executive. Now tell me, is CS exams just for exams? No, it is for life. When you even connect with a movie, you will be able to understand. Many people would remember Tamil movie, Papanasam, and the Malayalam movie, Drishyam. You would have definitely come across people from Tamil and Malayalam would definitely know about it. I'm not going to talk about Mohanlal, I'm not going to talk about Kamal Hassan, but when there is going to be two couple, remember Drishyam 1 or Papanasam 1, when there are two people, a couple who are old age, when they come to the tea shop and when they wanted to get their own property, the tea wala would say, try go for a habeas corpus. That is a writ that you can file, which is called habeas corpus, to get your property for your own self. Habeas corpus should be studied in Constitution of India. Now you should understand, don't see movie as a movie, see movie as a law. The more you try to do, there are various movies, technology related movies, where there will be CBCAD inquiries. Automatically you should go to Information Technology Act Amendment 2000, Amendment 2008. Immediately you should go to Right to Information Act 2005. Automatically you will be able to remember that. So that's the connection you need to give. Okay, now coming back from this year, let's come back to Indian Penal Code 1860 and criminal procedure. See, all the negative things or the possibilities of the negative outcomes will be discussed here. What and all? What is cheating? What is forgery? What is defamation? These type of negative words will be asked from Indian Penal Code. What is cognizable offense? What is non-cognizable offense? Guys, I will tell you this. Again, I'll go back to your movie. Why I am connecting movies? Because that is what you know. If I say criminal procedure code, you blink. If I say Singham 1, Singham 2, you will understand. When the Singham, who is the police officer who wants to arrest the villain, he'll not be able to do justice. So he goes to the minister and say, I wanted a separate wing to arrest that person. He says, I will give you a letter. You don't need to get a warrant from the court or from any other authorities. You can go directly arrest him. When he goes to the villain will say, are you a kid? You should come back with a warrant to arrest me. Then Singham will say, I am not a normal fellow. I have brought you under a cognizable offense. Cognizable offense means what? Arrest without warrant. You don't need a warrant for you to arrest a person because the activity is not just civil, it is criminal activity. So what is non-cognizable? You can arrest only with a warrant. Then what is summoned that you will have to issue? What is the warrant? What is actually that? Everything will be studied. Now you will be able to understand what is cognizable and non-cognizable offense. Are we clear till 10 chapters, guys? Are we clear? So out of 17 chapters, we have already clear about what is going to be there in this 10 chapters. I hope it would have made you really, really, really strong. What did I start when I started? I told you it is not going to be the easiest of the chapter unless you know what is going to be there. You already know this right now. So it is going to be a cakewalk for you to continue. It'll be very easy. Now, shall we go to the remaining 7 chapters? Yes. Indian Evidence Act. When you go for the Chartered Accountancy course, CS alone may not be sufficient for us to connect with the concepts, because I take for CA, I take law, EAS, CSM, economics, I take 4 or 5 papers, including CA final law I take. So I wanted to give a connection between CA and CS because I don't see it as a profession, I see it for my life. So I'll come back with the CA. Now, the moment when you read auditing, you will read about standards on auditing. Definitely the Forward Academy or the LICA who runs the academy will know what I'm talking about. In auditing, there'll be something called audit evidence. Standards on auditing, 500, 501, 505, all that you will keep on be studying. What is evidence? For evidence, what is the documents you require? How you can substantiate that you can complete the audit? All this you will study under CA, standards on auditing, in auditing paper. Whenever you get a chance, please read that, the standards on auditing. Now, why am I connecting that? Because Indian Evidence Act 1872 will talk about all the type of evidences: primary evidence, secondary evidence, circumstantial evidence, documentary evidence. Like that, there are various evidences, and what is allowed as per the rule or court, what is not allowed, everything will be covered. So decent level of portions to be covered, so B category. Are we clear? Next, special court and tribunal. I'll connect the two things now. In CA final law, you will study about tribunal. In CS executive, in company law and setting up, you will be able to touch on the authorities, where you will study about national company law tribunal, national company law appellate tribunal, special court, session court, district court, subordinate court, or these courts you will study, because you should understand tribunal is the final fact-finding authority, court is the final law-finding authority. So you will study about both. So NCLT, NCLAT, benches, that means in different bench, who and all will be sitting, what is the hierarchy, what are the offenses if you do under that, how you will be punished, can you appeal against NCLT? Yes. You can go to NCLAT against NCLT. Can you go against NCLAT? Yes, sometimes you can go directly to Supreme Court also. That hierarchy and all you will study, but not a very important thing to be covered amidst all the other chapters. So I'll mark it as C category. Next, arbitration and conciliation. Whenever we wanted to file a case, there will be 2 people, correct? There will be an applicant, there will be a respondent, plaintiff and respondent. That's what we call in the law term. Now, when you go to a court and file a case, there will be 2 people and it will be an open court. All the people will be sitting there. So whatever that is happening between you and the other fellow and the court decision, it will all be known to you. You will say, sir, I don't want an open court. Can I go for a closed court? Is there anything like I can go like a closed court? Nobody is going to be there. Very confidential, but there will be a person who will take care of knowing about what I wanted to say and what the other person wants to say, so that we can have a verdict. Yes, you have an arbitration. In that, you will study about domestic arbitration. What is ICA? International Commercial Arbitration. What is the result they are going to give? They call this as arbitral award. Then what is the dispute resolution mechanism? Yes, ADR, alternate dispute resolution mechanism. Do we have an agreement for it? Yes, arbitration agreement. Now I may go in a quick speed when I wanted to tell all this, but the purpose is very simple. Listen to this video again and again so that you become really strong in what I wanted to, because this speed is important for us to read in a professional examination, correct? Though you listen one time, if you are not able to get it, do it 3-4 times. Automatically, you will be able to get it really, really strong. So all this arbitration, conciliation, it is not one fellow winning and another fellow losing. It is win-win situation. Both of the people should have a mutual consent decision making. So it's quite important, A category. Indian Stamp Act is very old, 1899. What they are talking about, the stamping, because whenever you wanted to have a deed or a document, there will be a stamp paper that will be attached. Now, what is that? Where it is told? What is the type of adhesive stamps you will use? E-stamping, electronic stamping. What is going to be patta? What is gugliyat? Write that. You will have various jargons which they have told right from the British time, and now it is still continuing in our country. So it's going to be important. But when you compare it with other chapters, it is not going to be so B category. Registration. Now I was talking about documents and evidence. You remember? See what I am trying to do? I am going to color this particular in a different color. Let me give another color. Yes, this color is different. Yes. Now I am going to connect this with Indian Evidence Act. Why? Sir, what is the connection? Do we have any connection to this? I told you, you remember, for any evidence, there should be a document. So what type of documents, all that you are going to study in Registration Act, how you are going to collect evidence, you will study this in Indian Evidence Act 1872. So the connection is between 1872 and 1908. So we are going to connect registration. What are the documents? What is the documents which should be compulsory registered? What are the documents which are optionally registered? What are the effect of non-registration? If I'm not registering, is that okay? Will the law allow me? All this you are going to study, but still it is very small. So I'll mark this as a C category. RTIA, Right to Information Act. Any case that you wanted to file against any person, a public interest litigation, or taking your exam papers from ICSA or ICA, revaluation, retotaling, whatever it is, all the law pertaining to that particular information that you wanted to collect from them should be under Right to Information Act 2005. So you should know about the features, the appeals that you can go under RTIA, because not everybody will be smooth. So you will have to go against them and appeal to the higher authority. Who is a PIO, public information officer? What is his job? How we are going to cover him? What are the documents that you will give? Everything you will do, but still it's a very small act. So C category. The last one I was talking about is Information Technology Act, Amendment 2008. Whatever is your electronic form, electronic records. Now you go to income tax return or you go to your annual return, 20A, 21B, whatever the forms, the MGT forms, whatever it is, everything is in the electronic form. Don't you think so, guys? All the records are electronic records. When you wanted to give a signature, you will not give a manual signature. What do we give? DS. What is DS? Digital signature. Beyond a digital signature, they have brought electronic signature. Beyond electronic signature, they have brought secure electronic signature. So all these are law related terms. All these are law related terms. We need to be careful in knowing about what is that e-governance, how it is going to cover, and what are the flow of you covering through your Information Technology Act will be there. Though it is going to be important, it is small. So I am marking it as C category. Now, you should understand the colors that I have given between this and all will not be there in your study material. Guys, if you have opened your study material and seen what is there in JIG, you will understand how much we would have done a smart work. Leave alone the smart work. it has to be made easy. That's the only purpose of we being a faculty, correct? When it is tough, when we already say it is going to be a tough paper, you don't need a faculty like me to tell that it is tough. You itself know it. What is the purpose of the faculty is to provide the knowledge, what information you know, that information has to be converted into knowledge. And they should say that this is the way that you should connect. Even though the study material is raw, you need to convert into information and then into knowledge. This is what we do in valuation of inventories. People who also know about accounts may know it. Raw material, work in progress, finished goods. Zig, when you don't know anything about paper, you will only be more like a raw material. Today, after this session, you would have almost been at WAP. You will say, sir, I know something about what you have told. I did not understand it 100%, but still I know, okay, this particular act we have, I know that there are 17 chapters. I know the examination pattern. I know there are doctrines, jargons, maxims, appeals, authorities, definitions, differentiates between, then all these things relating to the acts and procedures. I know that all these are there. That is enough for you to complete for just half an hour of what we did in Zig. Zig is going to be jurisprudence, interpretation, and general law. Now, how to make it very simple, guys? See what I have done. I have done just 7 things to be covered when you wanted to do daily 1 hour practice. I have done from 1 to 7. What is 1 to 7? 1 hour of practice. 2 hours of watching our recorded videos. That should help, because beyond 2 hours, you need to write it and see. Any 3 tough questions per day if you take. Tough questions only. I'm not going to make you study easy questions for Jig, and you don't need me as a faculty for it. 4 sessions writing practice. Morning, afternoon, evening, and during the night time. 4 sessions, you need to write it and see, and only then you can see whether your memory is working or not. Then you listen, you will say like, yes, I understood. I understood everything. Write it and see. Then you will understand how much you have understood. So that becomes a practice. 5 maxims or 5 jargons per day, which you don't understand. Ejusdem generis, nocitaria socisis, contemporanea exposio, mens rea, consensus ad idem. Like that, I wanted you to remember jargons and maxims. Now you would not have understood whatever I have said. All these are jargons that we have in jurisprudence, interpretation, and general law. So 5 maxims and 5 jargons per day with explanation, write it and see. 6 easy questions, 3 tough questions, 6 easy questions, almost some 10 questions means some 1 month you will be able to finish Jig fully. 7 days a week, daily touch on something in Jig so that you don't miss the flow. Something, a lessons roundup or a small mock test paper or a suggested answer. I wanted you to do something to ensure that you are always in touch with that. So what are the types of questions to concentrate? I have already told this. Who defined what? That is going to be very important. All the definitions, you need a separate list. All the concepts or terms, you need a separate list. All the doctrines that I told in different chapters, separate list. All the rules, regulations, numbers, and points, separate. Articles in Constitution of India, Article 14 means what? 19 means what? 20, 21, 32, all that you should study. Jargons, I already told you now. Maxims, how we wanted to cover the Latin or a Greek or a French term. Penalty list, what is important penalty you cover? What are the procedures before the authorities? Within what time you should do what? All this has to be done. Next, non-compliances. If you do something, great. The law is going to accept. If you don't do something, it is going to be punishable. Those questions they'll ask in the exam. Appeals to against one person to whom I will go and appeal. All these things I wanted you to concentrate for you to cover your Jig. Guys, what I have done, I have taken questions for all these chapters. See what I'm doing. Chapter 3, chapter 4, chapter 5, 6, 7, 8. Like that, I have prepared questions. So I am ready to take up the classes relating to it, but you should know how important for you to break it open. Guys, this 17 is going to be, this 17 chapters coverage is going to be more like a Bhagavad Gita, Bible, or Quran. Take it really strong, write it and keep, prepare the list that you wanted to, then you come and attend our class. It is going to make your job very simple. If we can do it for Jig, company law setting up under us, it is going to be easy. Correct? Lika, there will be different faculties. SMA, I will be able to take again these subjects. Irrespective of wherever you attend, it is all going to be okay. But the point is very simple. Study law for life and not just for exams. So I hope you would have covered all these things taking up. So we can also help you doing this to the next level. Yeah. Okay. So if there is any questions relating to the preparation or whatever, if there is any doubts, you can shoot out for 5 minutes and then we can close the session. Is anybody having any doubts? They are open to ask. I can wait for a minute or two. If you have any questions, you can come back now. Or if you wanted to ask questions, you can get my number also. I will make it really, really strong. You can collect it from the academy or you can take it from here. 6374510690. You can take it from here and you can ensure that you can WhatsApp me on all the details relating to it. Or if you know the academy directly, you can contact them. If it is going to be perfect, then we can close. Yes. Now there is one question from Arvind. What is the maximum marks we can get in Jigal? I have seen people getting 85, 90 marks and all. Arvind, 90 marks is easily gettable when you know how to crack this particular paper. Now, what I have told in the micro level, if you do it in a macro level, easy 80, 90 you can get. I've seen many people who have got 70 under me, 75 under me. So I am no surprised if they concentrate more. Whatever I have told, if they practice again 2-3 times, I think they'll be able to get 80, 85 very easily. Yes, thank you. So if there is any other questions, you can come back to me in WhatsApp and we will be able to help you really, really stronger. Okay. So thank you, dears, for all the patient listening. I wanted you to take this as a very main subject because the first paper itself is going to be very important, crucial. If you crack the first paper very easily, remaining papers is going to be a cakewalk. I can also share the ABC analysis. Please come back to me. I'll be able to help you. We'll be able to do that. Thank you so much.